Hello, my name's Simon Rule. I'm a professor of haematology at the Peninsula Medical School in Plymouth, and I'm a consultant haematologist in Dereford Hospital, Plymouth, which is where I'm sitting right now. So if there's relapse evidence, so we notice some lymph glands, or you notice some lymph glands, and we do a scan and there it's clearly back. At that stage, we need to reassess the disease from scratch, really. The first thing to say is, you may not have the same symptoms you had the first time around. Often you do. So if you didn't have symptoms to start with, when the disease relapses, you probably won't have symptoms again. There's one scenario where it's slightly different. Low-grade lymphomas or indolent lymphomas can transform, change into aggressive forms of lymphoma. And that's a different clinical scenario altogether, and in that situation patients will often have symptoms that one gets with high-grade lymphomas: night sweats, fevers, weight loss. So if somebody with a previously indolent lymphoma suddenly develops lots of symptoms like that, then that makes us consider the possibility that there's been transformation. So that's why it's always important to do a repeat biopsy when the disease comes back, to make sure that you're dealing with the same disease you had in the first place, or whether it's changed slightly, because that influences the way we're going to treat you. So all the same staging investigations that happened at diagnosis happen at relapse. So it will depend on a lot of factors, such as how old the patient is, how fit the patient is, how long they've been in remission — that's a very important factor — whether they got a remission in the first place or not, and what you're trying to achieve. The other thing is the whole approach of watch and wait also applies when the disease comes back. So let's say we treat you 7 years down the track, we notice some lymph glands have come back, we do a scan, the lymph glands are small and the patient is well, then watching and waiting again at that point is the appropriate thing to do. So you don't need to rush into treatment should the disease come back after original therapy. So that whole watch and wait approach applies again later on. The majority of patients, usually what we're doing is we're going to give an alternative chemotherapy to what we use in the first place. So whatever the treatment you had initially, let's say it's 3, 4, 5 years down the track, or often longer, then we'll just give a different chemotherapy with a rituximab again, and you'd expect to get a good reaction that time as well. So there are a whole range of new drugs that are active across lymphomas, particularly in some types of low-grade lymphoma, that aren't chemotherapy. And the way they work is that we're starting to understand the mechanism within the lymphoma cell that's keeping the cell alive. So the cell is constantly signaling to itself to stay alive. So as we understand those pathways, drugs are being developed to interfere with that signal to tell the cell to stay alive. The cell therefore dies, and that's not a signal that your normal cells are dependent on. So it's very tumor specific. So there are a range of these drugs that are being developed, and the speed of the development of these drugs is really quite rapid. So it's always worth asking your doctor, you know, are there some trials of drugs available? It may not be applicable to you, but it's always worth asking the question, because there are some interesting drugs, some very active drugs that are currently being trialed right now, and that's going to be an ongoing pattern for a long period of time.
With relapse, the reaction is different to the first diagnosis, because the first diagnosis is something new, come to you cold, you know, didn't know about it, hadn't thought about it or anything before. But perhaps being a bit older, perhaps being a bit more relaxed or something, it was more or less what I expected. So I just dealt with it and thought, oh, that's a pity. So it got to, in the second time round, I would drop off to sleep during the infusions and get woken up because I'd moved and the buzzer had gone off or something. Whereas in the first time round, I was much more alert, watching to see what they were doing and you know, and learning from it. I think it was probably maturity, experience, resignation or whatever, but I was far more relaxed And even though I got the blood infections, I think the second time round was much easier to handle.
So the thing with indolent lymphomas is that you can have more than one relapse, and that's often the case, in fact, particularly with younger patients. So having, say, watched for a while and then treated, there'll be a period of remission, usually when quality of life goes completely back to normal. Then it'll relapse, we'll treat again. And then generally you're going to see a pattern of ongoing relapse. And generally speaking, your first treatment gives you the longest remission, and then subsequent treatments give shorter and shorter remissions. And how you manage those multiple relapses, again, depends entirely on fitness of the patient, what you're trying to achieve, where the relapse is, and what drugs you've got available. So the other thing is, unlike some situations, even some types of aggressive lymphoma, multiple relapses can be effectively treated. So you can retreat this disease on numerous occasions. I've got patients who've had over 10 different treatments over long periods of time.